Applying a computer cut paint mask to a curved surface is problematic, so let's dive in. I plan to use three separate vinyl masks in order to paint the logo on the side of this motorcycle tank. The first will create a drop shadow around the logo. The second will be the base coat as well as a very thin outline around the logo to separate it from the graphics that are already on the tank. And the third will be for the blue. This tank is not as curved as some other things that we might work on, like say a motorcycle helmet, but it's curved just enough to create some issues. This mask was cut with sharp line vinyl. This is the same vinyl that I have used for years. It works great, but it has some inherent weaknesses when it comes to working on curved surfaces, beginning with how we're going to apply the mask. So the traditional method that I like to use has always been the hinge method, which means I'll take a strip of masking tape and apply it somewhere down the center of the mask. Burnish that down good, and then the idea is to lift one side, remove the backing, stick this side down, and then we can remove the tape and do the same on the other side. The downside on a curved surface is this doesn't want to lift. For that reason, I prefer to remove the backing sheet from my paint mask and apply it directly to the curved surface I'm working on. So you notice that I've got these two pieces of 1/8 inch vinyl tape laid out on the tank, and that's for alignment purposes, so that I know where I want to place the paint mask onto the surface. Once I'm happy with the placement, I want to take the center . Got ahead of myself there. I should make sure that I am happy with the placement before I do that. Once I'm relatively happy with the placement, I'm going to start pushing this down from the center out. And the problem with curved surfaces is this vinyl is not going to want to lay very flat. Hopefully the camera is picking up these large wrinkles on this particular mask. So we have some issues with this particular vinyl mask. The biggest issue that we're facing right now is we have all of these wrinkles where the mask is not laying down flat because, again, we're working on a curved surface. The way we can deal with the mask not laying flat with these wrinkles in the mask is to take a razor blade or an X-Acto knife, whichever you prefer, and you can cut the mask where those wrinkles are. That will allow you to press down the vinyl so that it is in good contact with the actual surface that you've applied it to. In order to keep paint from finding its way into where you've cut the mask, you can simply place some masking tape over the mask where you've cut slits into it. It will take some time to go around this entire mask, cutting each one of these little wrinkles in the mask, especially the ones where we're meeting the actual portion that we will be painting. These up here, I'm not too terribly concerned about. The only thing you need to worry about with those is over time, that wrinkle can get larger and work its way down to the point where we're actually going to be applying paint. The other issue I have with this method is, you see I've got my registration marks cut into this vinyl mask. If you're not familiar with how I use those, you can check out the link in the top corner of the video, and I will link another video that I created that shows you how I actually use those. The downside with the registration marks in this particular case is, because this mask is not laying perfectly flat, we're not going to be able to use those registration marks. The other problem with this vinyl is, I mentioned earlier that I'm going to be using three separate masks to paint this logo. If I can't use the actual registration marks that I have cut into the mask itself, my only choice for registering the additional masks is to lay them directly over this mask. The problem with that is this vinyl is very opaque. You cannot see through it. I want to take a minute and backtrack, because I'm not convinced that I did an adequate job of explaining the points that I was trying to make previously. I talked about how the registration marks on our mask were no longer going to be usable. Why is that? The problem is, again, we're dealing with a curved surface, and it's not just curved horizontally, but it's also curved vertically. That means that we cannot lay this mask perfectly flat without any wrinkles on the surface. Each one of those wrinkles distorts the mask slightly, so each one of those wrinkles is going to throw the accuracy of our registration marks off. It may be just a tiny bit, but they're not going to be where they were designed to be once the mask has been applied. The problem with that is, when I come in to put the next mask over the top of the previous mask, there's no guarantee that those wrinkles are going to appear in the exact same places that they did the first time, which again throws off your registration marks. Why that becomes important is because I mentioned I'm going to be using three separate masks to paint this logo on this tank. The first mask actually looks like this. This is just for the drop shadow around the logo. The second mask will be the mask that you guys have already seen, which is this one. This is an outline of everything that was just there. It wouldn't be extremely difficult to try and eyeball this when you're lining it up, but again, the vinyl that I normally use is opaque. You cannot see through it, and that makes that even more difficult. The third and final mask is this one. This will be the blue. And the blue on this entire logo has a very thin silver outline surrounding the entire logo. So you notice the Folds of Honor lettering is quite a bit smaller than the mask we were using just a moment ago. Trying to line this up over the silver base coat that we will have applied at the time is very problematic, because all of this is smaller than what we're trying to line it up over. So the chances of getting that outline off in one direction or another are extremely high if you cannot see what you're doing. The fact that the vinyl that I usually use is opaque is a huge problem. This picture from just a few minutes ago illustrates that very clearly. If you look at the actual vinyl mask, you cannot see through the mask in order to make out the stripes on the side of this tank. Now, in cases where I am painting a logo that is a single color, so we only need one mask in order to create the logo, then you can throw all of this out the window. In those cases, I will simply use the traditional vinyl that I've always used. I will cut the wrinkles on the mask so that I can lay them flat. You want to be very careful when you're cutting those wrinkles on the mask. You do not want to cut into the surface that you're painting or score the surface that you are painting. That can cause delamination issues later down the road. But once I've got the wrinkles cut and I've got the mask pushed down to where it's laying flat on the surface, then I'll take some tape, cover those cuts so that I don't get any paint bleed where I've cut them, and then you can paint it and move on. For cases like this, where accurate registration is imperative because you're dealing with multiple layers, then I hope all of this makes sense. If it's still a little bit cloudy at this point, trust me, it will make more sense next week when I show you the other method that you can use for this, because as it turns out, there is a better way. Unfortunately, we don't have time to cover all of that in this video. So next week, we will cover actually painting the logo on this tank, and I'll show you exactly what I use in order to pull this off. So I hope you guys got something out of this. If you did, remember to like, subscribe, and share. I'm Trevor with Wicked Art Studio, and I'll see you guys next week.